If you want to go to that next level of Premiere Pro experience, then there are a couple of effects from your library that you should know about. These are popular effects that are used for many applications, so let's see which one they are and how they work. What up guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome to another exciting Premiere Pro tutorial. This time we're going to take a look at 5 very popular effects from the library that are used very often and they have many applications, so let's get right into it. The first one that you should know about is the transform effect. Let me just search that from here, transform right here under distort. I'm going to drag that to my first example here. It's just a simple text file and the transform effect actually has all the basic properties that you can also find in the motion here on top, and those are the anchor point, position, the scale, etc. Now why should you use this effect over the standard properties? Well, here's why guys. I'm going to animate this text, for example the position. I'm going to put this text outside of the canvas, create a keyframe for that, go a little bit forward in time and bring that back into the frame like so. And if I'm going to play this, we'll just have a standard animation, something that we could have also created with the normal properties here on top. But this effect has an extra option. Down below here, you can uncheck Use Composition's Shutter Angle and set one of yourself. And that way, we can also add a little bit of motion blur to this text, which makes it more natural. So I'm going to set the shutter angle here to 180 degrees, which is a standard motion blur. And right away, you can see kind of what it does here to the text. If we're going to set this number higher, so for example, 250, then you will see that there's going to be more motion blur to it. And now the animation looks a lot more natural because of this motion blur. So if you are doing any sort of animations, always make sure to use the transform effect for that. Let's have a look at this second example right here. This time I'm going to search for the track mat key inside my effects library. And it's right here underneath the keying. What I have here in this example, guys, is on top I've got this graphic here. And these are just 2 rectangles that I've put on top of each other. Nothing more than that. You can actually create any kind of shape that you want. You can do that, by the way, from the pen tool down below here. And just draw your own shape or use any of the presets, such as the rectangle tool or the ellipse tool. And what we can do now is kind of map the clip that we have down below here, which is this waiter, to that graphic. So let's do that. I'm going to drag the track mat key to that clip below. And from the properties here, I'm going to say that the mat is going to be on video channel number 2, which is that graphic that I've created. And right away, you will see that it will use that graphic as the mat. And now we have this image and our nice creation here. And a great thing is that we can always change the graphics afterwards. For example, I can take this shape here and kind of move it elsewhere. And you'll see that we can create different shapes from that. So this is definitely an effect that is used very often to create custom transitions, because we can also animate these graphics here, of course. We can let them come in here from the right, for example, and do all sorts of things. All right, so that's it for the second effect that you should always know about. Let's head over to the third one. I'm going to go back to my effects library and just search for the basic 3D. Also an effect that I believe is overlooked sometimes. We can actually create some sort of a 3D effect inside Premiere Pro. It's not the same as an After Effects, of course, but it's all about the ending result. And I do believe that often for these small things here, that this basic 3D effect has some cool things here. We can create nice animations, for example, have it kind of turn around a couple of times here to then reveal a sort of text. Or you can also work with like multiple layers in here and make some sort of a cover flow effect where you have like different objects coming in and out, but kind of have that 3D effect to it. So for example, this text here starts first here on the left side, you know, and as it kind of comes in here from the right, we then also kind of swivel that so that it sits straight. And that way we kind of have this more 3D effect to it. I'm actually using this a lot also. Another great application is to use this inside lower thirds animations, where you have kind of the text coming in here on the bottom and you want to create this nice animation over it. Well, just kind of use the basic 3D here to have it do something. For example, we can let it come in from the right side. So let's just do that quickly. I'm going to create a keyframe for the position. And actually I should be using the transform effect right now. So I'm sorry for that. Don't pay too much attention to it. All right, so the swivel effect, also I'm going to create a keyframe for that and just let that go to the 0. And now we kind of have something going on like this. There we go, a nice additional movement to the text that is coming in. Also tons of possibilities. Now guys, I want to take a very quick break to thank the sponsor of this video, which is Storyblocks. It's a huge library full of stock footage, as you can see right here. They also have things like assets, like explosions and muzzle effects, etc., that you can all download unlimited with an account on this website. You also have tons of templates, for example, these nice title animations here, and also lots of stock footage like we've seen before. Now, guys, there's also something pretty cool here that they've introduced. You can actually get some nice discounts if you are signing up today at videoblocks.com. For example, you can actually get 20% off a full year on a Premiere Pro subscription. Also, if you are a Vimeo Pro user, then also there you can find some nice discounts. To find out more information about all of these great things, just visit the first link in the description below, and that will bring you straight to their website. But we have two more awesome effects, so let's check them out. In the next one, we've got this pretty girl walking, looking into the lens, but something went wrong here, guys. Actually, we weren't allowed to film her. So what I've done here is duplicated that layer and actually created a mask around her face and tracked that mask together with her. And this is actually being used very often. You can also do this on license plates, etc. And in the effects library, what I'm going to do now is search for MOSAIC. There we go. And just drag that to that second layer, like so. And because I've masked her face out from the opacity here, let me just disable that first layer just for a moment so that you can see what we're actually working with here. Just her face that has been masked like so. So right here, we've got that MOSAIC effect onto it, and we can actually change how many blocks that you want in here. For example, let's put this on 50 to 50 ratio, and now we have got this very natural blurred out face, like so. Something that is also used very often is just the normal Gaussian blur, and here I also have a nice tip for you guys. I'm going to search for blur in the effects library right here, the Gaussian blur. You've probably heard about this before, but what I do want to show you guys are these kind of these icons here on the right side. You've probably noticed them before, but might never ask yourself, what are these icons? Well, the first one here is pretty important, actually. It stands for that it is an accelerated effect, and this means that it goes together with your graphical cards, meaning that it will render a lot faster. If I'm dragging this Gaussian blur on top of the first layer here, and then we'll just set that blur, for example, to 20, or even more, let's set that to 50, because she cannot be recognizable, and I can just play this back in real time very fast. But if I'm going to take something else like the camera blur here, which doesn't have that icon of the accelerated effect here in this first column, then you will see that I'll have some more trouble to render this. So I'm going to stand in the beginning of this clip, play this back, and you'll see that it just takes a while before it starts, and it definitely not plays back smoothly. So if you want to save time, then always go for that Gaussian blur, or just look for other effects that have that same icon here next to it, which will render a lot faster. All right, and then there's one last effect that I believe any advanced Premiere Pro user should know about. I'm going to go to my clips folder right here. I don't have it in my timeline yet because it actually works before we are going to drag this into the timeline. Right here, guys, I've got a shot of a girl that I was following with this bouquet, and I actually had my camera upside down on the Ronin gimbal, so we kind of need to flip this image, and there are two ways to do that. We can drag this clip into the timeline and then kind of do it, but I always like to look for the correct shot here in this long clip. For example, right here, set my endpoint and my outpoint, and then drag that into the timeline. But it's very hard to kind of focus on what's actually happening here because it's upside down. So I'm just going to go to my effects and look for the flip. And we actually have two flips here, the horizontal flip and the vertical flip. This is something that a lot of users forget, but if you are filming upside down, you actually have to flip it both horizontally and vertically. And by holding down the CTRL key, you can actually select both of these effects and drag that into the source monitor on your clip. And this way you can now kind of view this clip in the source monitor while it's flipped. And for example, I'm going to pick out some nice shot here, right here, where she's kind of picking up one of those marshmallows or whatever that is. And then eats that up. So I'm going to take this shot right here and drag that into the timeline like so. And it will kind of remember that so I don't have to add those effects back into it. So this is definitely something that's used a lot, and I believe not really an effect that you're going to do much with in your edits. So that's why you can already put this effect on your clip before you're actually going to bring this to the timeline. Alright guys, that was it again for this awesome tutorial, or more of an information video. If you have any other effects that any advanced Premiere Pro user should know about, let me know in the comments below. It's very nice to share that with the community. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe to our channel, and as always, stay creative.